My Awesome Husband. Chapter 1. Sign this divorce agreement and go to the Civil Affairs Bureau with Bella tomorrow. Chase Lu raised his head and saw his mother-in-law, Jane Zhang, throwing two sheets of paper in front of him with disgust. A beautiful woman with a pale face stood behind her. She was Chase's wife, Bella Song. Everyone in Golden City knew about her. She was blessed with outstanding beauty, but her marriage was inferior and lowly. Everyone in Golden City knew that she married a good-for-nothing guy. Seeing that Bella was cold as ice, Chase's heart ached. His hands trembled as he picked up the divorce papers. Finally, the day was arriving. When Bella saw Chase picking up the agreement, her expression darkened and she turned her face away. She had given up on her husband, who had been protecting her for the past 10 years. Chase, I still remember. 10 years ago, on a snowy night, you were dressed in rags and held a wooden stick in your hand. You didn't know me, but in order to protect me, you were bitten by stray dogs all over your body. Still, you refused to retreat. Using the stick as a sword, you became my knight in shining armor. From then on, I began to admire you. You are a hero in my heart. I still remember your courage. What about you? Over the past few years, you have lost all your enthusiasm and courage. Look at yourself now. You speak softly every day. You even refuse to retaliate whenever I hit or scolded you. Are you still a man? I really don't want to see you like this. I have been waiting for you for 10 years. But you have also let me down for 10 years. If only you had taken a stand and objected to these divorce papers today. Then, I would have given myself to you for the rest of my life. Unfortunately, you didn't. You didn't even have the courage to keep your wife. Perhaps it'd be better if we just end this here. At the thought of this, Bella could no longer hold back the tears in her eyes and turned to leave. However, Jane looked at Chase with disgust, feeling extremely satisfied. 10 years ago, her silly daughter had saved a homeless kid and insisted that he stay at their home. Since then, the kid had been in their home for 10 years. Her daughter even tried her best to get everyone's approval of this boy. 3 years ago, she finally got married to him. The news caused a sensation in the whole of Golden City. The Song family, which was revered by many because of Bella's beauty, had become the laughingstock due to this matter. Since then, the family had been unable to recover from it. The goddess of the city had married a poor worthless guy. The joke had been circulating in Golden City for 3 years. Now, her daughter finally understood. As long as her daughter divorced this guy, she would be able to start a new life in Golden City with her incomparable appearance. Alfred Gaw, who had been pursuing Bella for a long time, seemed to be a good candidate. His family is rich and powerful. Recently, the Song family had also asked for help from the Gaw family. Sign it. My daughter is going on a date with Alfred Gaw tomorrow. Jane cursed at Chase's unmoving figure. Chase sighed and put away the divorce agreement. He said coldly, "Just give me a moment. I was making a soup for Bella." Jane looked disdainfully at Chase. Over the past 10 years, this guy had always put on a sour face, as he didn't take the Song family seriously at all. Only Bella could make him smile. Who do you think you are? You better sign it. Jane urged again and left the kitchen. After they left, Chase suddenly smiled bitterly, and his eyes were filled with tears. He looked at the pot of bubbling soup, and his eyes were burning. Bella, do you know why I don't fight or retaliate all these years? Because you are sick. Your body is weak. So you cannot be provoked. You would always get sick at the end of the month. And it was unbearable for you every time. So I just couldn't bear to aggravate you even further. If it weren't for the fact that I have added medicinal herbs to this pot of soup every month, you wouldn't have been able to last for more than 15 years. Just one more year, and you would be completely recovered. It is a pity. Just 1 year. Why can't you give me another year? Are you really disappointed in me? My true identity is something you still do not know. Because of that one sentence of yours. Because you said that you needed company. I had stayed by your side for 10 years. At the thought of this, Chase's heart ached terribly. But at this time, his cell phone rang. He picked up the phone and frowned slightly. It was a phone number that had not appeared for 10 years. Was it possible that his family? Hello. Chase answered immediately. At the other end of the phone came an old and sorrowful voice. Young master, the old master had passed away last night. His words were like a thunderclap. And Chase was in shock. Grandpa, he has passed away, Chase lamented in his heart. Chase was born into an aristocratic family with famous medicinal skills. They were the Lu family from the north. His parents died early. He had been envied and hated by other people in the family because of his talents since he was a child. His grandfather was the only one who doted upon him. But in the end, in order to keep him safe for the rest of his life, his grandfather had faked Chase's death and sent him out of toxic household. He wanted to keep him safe from all the pernicious politics and ulterior motives in the family. It was also on the first night when he was wandering on the street that he met Bella, the girl who had made his heart ache for the longest time. Young master, the old master has been paying attention to you in silence. All these years, he has also been cultivating power for you. There is also a letter he wants to pass to you. I will pick you up now, the man on the phone said chokingly. Chase agreed. After hanging up the phone, he sat directly on the ground. The one who often carried me on his shoulder and liked to stab my little face with his stubble. Who sneaked into my room in the middle of the night. Taught me medicinal skills. And knocked on my head whenever I fell asleep. Grandpa's gone. Chase did not notice that his face was full of tears. It was not until thick smoke and a smell of burnt food wafted over that Chase's attention was roused. Thanks for listening to the Bravonovel audiobook. Welcome to download the Bravonovel app. Read the novel My Awesome Husband online and get the latest updates.